We've run into vectors of unit length before, the standard basis vectors. Now let's look at those, okay? Here we have the standard basis vectors in 3 space, and they are the vectors 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. Now, it's more than that these vectors are of length 1. The other nice property of this set of vectors is that they are orthogonal to each other. Now, a set of vectors that has this property, that they are of unit length and they are mutually orthogonal, are known as mutually orthonormal vectors. So, a set of vectors U0, U1 through UN minus 1, there's n of them, which is a set in CM, is said to be mutually orthonormal. How can we elegantly express that? Well, if we look at the vector index with I, and we take the dot product with this vector indexed with j, then either it evaluates to 1. When does it evaluate to 1? When I is equal to j, because then this is just the square of its length, but its length has to be 1. Or it evaluates to 0 otherwise. Why? Because if I is not equal to j, then we want those two vectors to be orthogonal to each other. So the formal definition is given in the notes. Conceptually, this is what's going on. Now, what do we like to do in this course? In this course, we often like to take vectors and make them into the columns of a matrix. Let's have a look what happens if you take mutually orthonormal vectors and make them the columns of a matrix. Okay, now, for historical reasons, when we start talking about such matrices, we tend to use the letter Q for the columns. So I'm going to change the U here to a Q and say, okay, we have n mutually orthonormal vectors Q0 through Qn minus 1, all in CM, and we know that they have this property right here. Now let's take those vectors and let's make them the columns of a matrix. What happens if you look at Q Hermitian transpose times Q? Well, that's Q0 through Qn minus 1 Hermitian Q0 through Qn minus 1. Taking the Hermitian transpose of this means that you make columns into rows, but you have to conjugate them as well, so we get Q0 Hermitian through Qn minus 1 Hermitian times Q0 through Qn minus 1. And that then is, let's see, it's a n by n matrix where the entries in the matrix are the dot products of all of these columns. Okay, the first entry is Q0 Hermitian Q0. The second entry is Q0 Hermitian Q1, and so forth. Okay. What do we know about the diagonal elements? They're all equal to 1. What do we know about the off-diagonal elements? They're all equal to 0. So there's clearly a nice relationship between a set of mutually orthonormal vectors. And the matrix that has this has these vectors as its columns. And a matrix that has the property such that Q Hermitian Q is equal to the identity, or in the real case Q transpose Q equal to the identity, is known as an orthonormal matrix.